Hello friends, welcome to our today's session on Spark. In this series, we are learning scenario based question on Spark, and in our today's video, we will see one of a scenario on how to handle a complex JSON string which is inside a data frames column. So here goes the question. We have an input CSV file in which we have a column called type, and inside that column type, we have a content which is related to a JSON string. Here, as you can see here, and the requirement here is we need to parse this JSON string and flatten the data as shown in the output data frame. Like here you can see we have a list inside the JSON which says fruit, apple, fruit, mango, fruit, orange, and we need to parse it in such a way we need it as a separate column, fruit 1, fruit 2, fruit 3, and we need apple, orange and mango respectively. So let us see how to solve this problem. We will solve this problem using both SparkWorks Scala as well as PySpark. So that being said, let us move on to our today's demo. We are into my Databricks Community Edition account. I have already started the cluster and also created a notebook. We will go through each and every steps and understand how we can achieve the output. So the data that we have for our today's demo, I have already uploaded it in the GitHub account. I will also give a link in the description. You can go ahead and download it in case you are trying it in your own machine. So that being said, let us look into the PySpark approach first. As usual, I am reading the CSV file that we have, and here you can see I am enabling two options, escape and then the multi-line. Since we have a JSON related string, it might lead into a multiple lines and also it might have some escape sequence. So I am enabling those two options in the while reading it, I am enabling these two options. So let me run this and also let me display the output. Let me give df1. So here you can see I have one column with one row, and inside that I have a JSON related string inside it. So as a first method, we will look into the JSON tuple. So for that, I am importing the packages that are required. And then what JSON tuple does is, if there is a JSON string in a column, in a Spark data frame column, then the syntax goes like this: JSON tuple and the column name type, and then the string inside the JSON which we need to extract. So inside here we need to extract the fruits, so I'm giving it as fruits, and then I am renaming it as a JSON split, and I am displaying. Let me run this. So here you can see it created a list, and inside that we have three items. So this is what the JSON tuple does. This we are going to use in our logic, and we are going to receive the output that we are expecting. So here you can see with JSON tuple, I am giving the input as type column and getting the fruit, and then I am converting this as a RDD, and I am using AST dot literal evaluation so that it will evaluate the JSON string whether it is in appropriate format or not. And then what I am doing is I am extracting the each and every columns, each and every elements in the position 0, 1 and 2. So that's what I am doing. So here you can see, and then back again I am converting this RDD into a CSV again. So let me run this. So here you can see we have received the output, but the one thing to be noted is we don't have a correct schema. If we want to rename it as fruit 1, fruit 2, fruit 3 from this data frame, we need to add one more step with column renamed C01 to fruit 1, C01 to fruit 2, C02 to fruit 3. Like that we have to rename it. So that is the first method that we have tried now. This is a bit complex. Let us try the second method, which will be somewhat straightforward. So this one is from JSON. So from JSON, for this from JSON, we, as you all know, we need a schema to be passed to get the from JSON. So what I am doing is, for that, first I am extracting the schema. I am giving a data frame column which has a JSON string, and then I am passing it to the map function, and I am getting the schema. So let me run this. And let me also display the schema for you guys. So here you can see it is created a schema of struct type, and inside that we have a list and array type as well. So you can see it in such a way. And let me run this next command. So now you can see what I have did is I have used a from JSON. I passed the type column and I have passed the schema that we have did above. And I have renamed the column as JSON-str. So let me print the schema. I mean, like, let me print the output first. Display int JSON. So here you can find the JSON string, and this is the type string, and this str, JSON-str, is of type struct. So here you can see it is struct array elements. So from this we can easily query it. We can give just a select statement. We can query the element at position 0, 1 and 2, and we can give allies of fruit 1, fruit 2 and fruit 3, and we can extract the output as we are expecting. So let me run this as well, the final step. So by this way, the from JSON as well as the JSON tuple will be useful if there is a complex JSON string inside the column of Spark data frame and we need to flatten it in such a way, then these two will be useful. So this is for PySpark. Now let us switch on to the Scala, Spark with Scala. So for this, I'm using a magic command as usual, %scala. Since it is a Pythonic notebook, I am using %scala. And as a first step, I am reading the CSV file that we have. Let me display the DF1 as well. So it is taking some time, got completed. So the same result. So now here it is a bit tricky. I didn't find any options for JSON tuple. So I am giving only one method with from JSON alone. So here you can see I am exporting the importing the from JSON function, and here goes the method, the same approach as that of PySpark. We are defining a schema and we are using that schema in the from JSON to get the JSON data. So this is what the approach is. So for that, for this we are also implementing the function called schema of JSON. So from that we are extracting the JSON columns. You can see here schema of JSON, and then inside this I am passing the string column, like only the first row of the string data that we have, I mean JSON string data that we have. So that one I am passing it to get the schema, and after that this schema I am passing it to the from JSON. So let me run this, and also let me display the schema as well. So here you can see the schema has a value of first column, first row, and it is of type struct. So let us do the same thing. Let me, before that, let me display the data first. %scala, and then display of DF2. You can see this is of type string and this JSON data is of type struct, inside which we have array elements as well. So by this way we can also run a query on that, stating that select statement, column name, and then we have to use get item here, get item 0, get item 1, get item 2, and I am giving allies name of fruit 1, fruit 2 and fruit 3, and I am running this query to get the required output. Sorry, we need to define the call function first. Let me import the call function. So I'm giving call and running this again. So here we go. We got the required output as from the JSON string. We have flattened the data and received the expected output as fruit 1, fruit 2 and fruit 3, and the respective apple, mango and orange. Hope you guys understood this concept better. Please try this on your own machine and let me know if you face any issues. I'm happy to help you guys. Thank you for watching this video. Please do subscribe to my channel and also give a thumbs up signal if you really like my content, guys. Thank you.